my story. I am from Georgia, as you guys know. I graduated from Kennesaw State. I studied genetics with a minor in statistics. For me, people have started calling me the fearless girl, real life fearless girl. And as much as I appreciate it, it is it's a big feat to have. What does that even mean? For me, I had a dream of coming to New York, very cliche, graduating on Timor Ballet. I knew I wanted to go to New York, but wasn't really sure for what. I did study genetics in college. I have a twin brother with cerebral palsy, and I wanted to go into counseling and help families the way that doctors told me when I was in college or throughout my life. Writing my senior thesis, I came to the conclusion that I know this is not what I want to do because research and science are very boring. Anybody that's doing it now, hats off to you. On the straightforward, I don't have mentors. Mentors is a funny word. I was reading a book called Lyons, I think. Not exactly going to somebody and saying, can you be my mentor? It's building and sharing relationships with people wanting to actually help you. And not that many of them didn't want to genuinely help you, but it's the special one that comes. So there's two men on the floor, Gordon Charlotte, who we call him Dr. Gordon Charlotte. He was amazing and will talk your ear off and a lot older. And then there is Ryan O'Day, who is a lot younger. He's 27. Ahead of me, but definitely dumbed things down for me, you know, made it very elementary. So I really appreciate the both of them just having the old and the new and how they explain everything even to this day and giving me advice that's beyond the training floor as far as, you know, what you want to do in your career and where you see yourself going, what you can do from this. And so mentors in any career, any industry are key. Building blocks in front of your career are really important. Your day can be consumed looking at the market, looking at the European markets, looking at news, looking at whatever. And so about 2 weeks ago, a month ago, I made an error. And it was on a Friday. And I remember my boss saying, at the end of the day, it's okay, just go home. But I really want millennials to hear the message. I don't want to be an anomaly. I don't want to be the only fearless person breaking glass ceilings or being fearless or going after my dreams. And I feel like if my story can connect with just one of you guys in this room for you to go on and do amazing things, I really truly want to hear that, because who is next in line to be presidents and vice presidents and CEOs of companies? It's us.